by their physical and chemical properties. Okay, so here are some of the examples of metal and non-metals here I have written. You know also, so some of the examples here it is written iron, gold, silver that are under metals. Non-metals, hydrogen, oxygen, okay, they are under non-metals. So again, some more metals and non-metals, the names you can just learn. Occurrence, where metals and non-metals are found. Generally, metals are found in the earth crust, in the mineral form. Okay, why metals are found as minerals inside earth crust, let me tell you about that. So if you all have remembered, we have discussed about the valence electrons in our earlier discussions. We had discussed about the valence electrons. Most of the metals, if you will see the electronic configuration of metals, then you can find that all the metals, they have extra electron in its valence shell. You take the example of sodium. Already we have discussed the electronic configuration of sodium. It got one valence or extra electron in its outermost shell so that it can share its, or it can give its electron, and that by giving the electron it will attain its octet. Means now it the outermost shell will be satisfied with 8 electron, and we can say that now it's a stable element. So like this, I just gave the example of sodium, but if you will analyze all other metals, you can find that most of the metals, they got valence electron in their outermost shell. I am not repeating what is valence electron, what is electronic configuration. Already we have discussed in the last videos. Okay, you can again refer to that videos if not remember. So that electronic configuration, if you will see for the metals, they got an extra electron in their outermost shell. So always they want to share the electron, and when they will share the electron with another element, another metal or another non-metal, they will form compound. Okay, so metals, most of the metals, mostly they exist in their compound state. Remember, as metals have valence electrons, and as they are highly reactive, they always in a position to react with other metals and non-metals because they have extra electrons. They want to share their electrons to attain stability. That's why mostly they form compounds. Okay, so most of the metals, they are found in their compound form inside earth crust. We can take the example of sodium, we can take the example of magnesium, aluminium. Okay, these are the most reactive metals which are present inside earth crust, and they are in their compound state. Means if we want to extract sodium or aluminium from the earth crust, means we cannot find the pure form of sodium or aluminium or magnesium, because as I said, they are highly reactive and they will be in the combined form with other metal or non-metal. So when these reactive metals, when they are extracted from the earth crust, again they are needed to be purified, or again they are needed to be separate. Sodium needs to be separate from its compound form. It will form compound with some other element. Got it? But some of the metals like silver, gold, or we can say platinum, they are not found in their compound state, rather they are found in their free state. What is free state? Means in their element form. Okay, and mostly gold and platinum, they are known as noble metals because they are not at all reactive. That's why we can wear gold as an ornaments, because gold is not reactive. Okay, and gold, we can extract gold from the earth crust in its pure form, mostly in its pure form. Platinum also can be extracted in its pure form because they will not react with any other element and they will not form compound. Rather, mostly they are present in their free state only. Okay, so we can say that metals, most of the metals, they form compound and found as a mineral inside the earth crust. Some of the metals, they are also found as a mineral and in their free state, not in the compound form, rather in their element form. We can take sodium and aluminium as in compound form, and gold, platinum, we can take in their free state. Okay, so we can say that, or we can write it as the opposites. If you will talk about non-metals, non-metals can also be found inside earth crust. Non-metals can also be found in atmosphere. Non-metals can also be found inside the water bodies. Okay, so these may be the occurrence of the non-metals. Okay, so here you can see the pie chart of the percentage of metals and non-metals in the earth crust. Okay, you can just go through the percentage by seeing the pie chart. You can easily identify what are the percentage of the metals and non-metals present inside the earth crust. And if you all can notice that aluminium is the most abundant metal which is present inside the earth crust, around 8.1%. Okay, and oxygen is the most abundant non-metal. Okay, aluminium is the most abundant metal and oxygen is the most abundant non-metal. Okay, if we will talk about water, then sodium is the most abundant metal present inside water, and around we can see the percentage calcium. Okay, calcium and bromine, they are the most abundant non-metals present inside sea. Okay, so by seeing the diagram, you can analyze the percentage of metals and non-metals present in the earth crust. So these are the, you know, types of metals and non-metals. Details about all the occurrence you will have in your paragraphs. Okay, so this is only an introductory part for metals and non-metals. Okay, now let us move on to the most important topic, the properties of metals and non-metals. Basing on what property we can differentiate a metal and a non-metal? Let us see that. Okay, it is very simple and easy to remember. Already I have made a table for you, and let us discuss all the properties in details. Okay, the first property is luster. Luster means shining. Okay, having a shine. Lustrous means having a shine. You can mostly observe that metals are lustrous. They are having shine. Okay, they are shining. And non-metals, they are non-lustrous. So here, like this I am doing. Okay. They are lustrous. They are not lustrous. Except lead. Lead is a metal which is not having shine. It is dull in appearance. And graphite and iodine are the non-metals which are, you know, having shine. Okay, which are lustrous. Here I have written the exceptions. Remember the exceptions. Learn the exceptions. Okay. So again, I am repeating. Luster. Metals are lustrous or they are shining. Except lead. Lead is a metal which is not lustrous. And the non-metals are non-lustrous or non-shining except graphite and iodine. Okay. The next one, ductility. Metals are ductile, but non-metals are not ductile or non-ductile. What is ductility? Ductility means when the substance is beaten, it should not break. Rather, it should be formed into thin wire. As we can take the example of copper wire. Copper wires are used in electric, you know, cables. Or iron wires. Okay, iron wires are also available. So metals are generally ductile. Means when metals are beaten, they will, you know, form a thin wire. Okay, they will form a thin wire. They have the capacity to form thin wire. They will not break down. metals, when non-metals are beaten, they cannot form wire, rather they will break into powder, except carbon fiber. Okay, except carbon fiber, all other non-metals can cannot be made into wire. Got it? Next, malleability. Metals are malleable, but non-metals are non-malleable. Okay, what is malleability? As I said, ductility means when it is beaten, it will form thin wire. Malleability means when it is beaten, it will form thin sheet. Okay, just like a paper, it will form a thin sheet. So when metals are beaten, it will form thin sheet rather to form powder, except zinc. Okay, zinc is a metal which cannot be made into thin sheet. Okay, it will convert into its powder form when it is beaten. And remember, gold is the most highly malleable metal. Okay, gold, among all the metals, gold is the highly malleable metal. We can, when it is beaten, it can be converted into thin sheet. But non-metals cannot be converted into thin sheets. Got it? Next, heat conduction. Heat conduction means whether they have the capacity to carry heat from one place to another place or not. Metals are the good heat conductors. Here I am writing good. Okay, and non-metals are bad heat conductors. Got it? Metals are the good conductors of heat. Non-metals are the bad conductors of heat. Except lead. Lead is a metal which cannot conduct heat. Got it? Lead is a metal which cannot conduct heat. Next, electrical conduction, the same. They can conduct electricity. That's why metals are used in the electric wires. Copper is used in the electric wire so that it can conduct electricity. Except tungsten. Okay, tungsten, here also I am writing, they are the good conductors of electricity, but non-metals are the bad conductors of electricity. Okay, tungsten is the exception. Here I have written some exceptions, just remember them. Tungsten is a metal which cannot conduct electricity. Here, one most important point I am going to tell you. Why metals are good conductors of heat and electricity? You can see, they are also good conductors of heat and they are also good conductors of electricity. Why they are good conductors of heat and electricity? As I said, always metals have an extra electron in their outermost shell. So when they are supplied with, heat or electricity, that extra electron will move out from the cell and it will carry the heat and electricity throughout the metal. Okay, suppose take this is the iron rod. Here we will supply heat. Then here all the valence electron, it will carry heat from this point up to this point. That's why when we will leave a spoon on the cooking pan, when we are cooking, making the lid of the, making the burner of the gas on, then after some time when we go and touch that spoon, we will feel hot. Because metals are the good conductors, they can conduct heat and electricity from one place to another place. Because they have valence electrons. That valence electrons will help them to carry heat and electricity from one place to another place. Okay? Next, sonority. Sonority means metals always form a ringing sound. Whenever we will allow metal, or when we will beat metal with any other surface, it will form a ringing sound. But non-metals cannot form ringing sound. Okay, so that is sonority. So metals can form ringing sound, or metals are sonorous, non-metals are non-sonorous. Okay, next, state. State means whether they are in solid state, liquid state or gaseous state. Okay, solid, liquid or gaseous. mercury. Okay, except mercury is found in its liquid state. You can find liquid mercury inside thermometer. Okay, mercury is a metal which is found in its liquid state, not in its solid state. And non-metals, they can be found in solid state, in liquid state, or maybe in gaseous state. Okay, non-metals, they can be found in the solid state, liquid state. We can take an example, carbon, solid state. Liquid state, we can take an example, bromine. Okay, bromine is a non-metal which is present in its liquid state. And gaseous state, we can take hydrogen, oxygen. Okay, so non-metals can exist in solid, liquid and gaseous state. Got it? Next one, melting and boiling point means the ability to melt and the ability to boil. So here, metals are having high melting and boiling point. Here I can write high melting point and boiling point, but they have low melting point and boiling point. Non-metals have low melting point and boiling point, rather metals have high melting point and boiling point, having some exceptions. Except sodium, potassium, mercury and gallium. These are the metals who have low melting and boiling point. And here also some exceptions like diamond and graphite are the two non-metals who got high melting and boiling point. Just remember the exceptions. Okay, these are very important. Next, density. I hope you all know what is density. Mass per unit volume. If on the basis of chemistry, I will tell you about density. Means more the particles are close, more will be the density. We can say that the density of solid is more than the density of gas. Density of liquid is more than the density of gas. Got it? Density of solid is more than density of liquid. So, more is the closeness of particle, more will be the density of the substance. Or in common, we can define it as mass per unit volume. More will be the closeness, more will be its mass, and more will be the density. So, metals are having high density. Okay? They are heavy. They have high density. Having some exceptions, lithium, sodium and potassium are the metals having low density. And non-metals are having low density except diamond, iodine and graphite. Except diamond, iodine and graphite, all other non-metals, they have low density. Strength. Strength means the ability to break. How strong they are. So we already know metals are having more strength than non-metals. Here I can write high. Here I can write low. With an exception, zinc. Zinc is a metal having low strength. That's why zinc is non-malleable. Understood? It is having low strength. So when it is beaten, it cannot form into sheet. Rather it will break. It will form into powder. And here, except carbon fiber. Okay? Hardness. Whether they are hard or not? Yes. Metals are hard. Non-metals are soft. Having one exception, sodium and potassium. Sodium and potassium are the metals which are soft. It can be also cutted by using knife. And diamond is a non-metal which is hard. Okay, so these are some of the properties basing on which we can identify whether it is a metal or a non-metal. Okay, by absorbing, if we can identify whether it is a metal or a non-metal. Okay, so just remember all of these things and remember the exceptions. You remember carefully. Okay, if the exceptions are very important. Okay, so these all are the properties. Again, in the next class, we will discuss the position of metals and non-metals in the periodic table. As I said, all the 118 elements can be differentiated into metals, non-metals, periodic tables in details. Okay, so till then just keep revising the topic, again go through the topic. If you got any more doubt, again you can ask me. Okay, revise the topic well, do not skip any of the topic. Okay, it is based on. And in the next class we will move on to some more new important chapter, more important topic.